Hi, my name is Fakayode Naomi Abiola. I am a pig farmer. I have a farm in a farm settlement here in Ibadan, Nigeria. Well, I started like 5 years ago. I started with just 2 pigs, 2 female. Then it started growing to the extent that it became like 40 pieces.
So what do you love about piggery business?
Okay. I love this piggery business because you can easily plan with it. You can plan and it will come out at the targeted time, and you make profits. And also, we really have issue of theft with it. It's a very, very rare cases. Outsiders cannot come into your farm and steal. It's very rare, except people that are around. And the mortality rate is very low.
Okay. Now, so what do you think is your biggest challenge right now?
Presently, in the last 2 years, we've been having the issue of swine fever. Because of this, a lot of people have been discouraged. New people that came in newly into the business have been discouraged. Except those of us that have been in it, and we know how it is, that still stayed. The issue with swine fever is that it has no cure. The moment it's already in a settlement or at a farm, everything has to be cleared.
What is something you would never give up?
One thing I will never give up on is rearing of animals. I love it so much. I do this. I also rear chickens. That's broiler. So anything that just brings in, you know, apart from the profit aspect of it, you know, it gives me joy when I do these things. I felt fulfilled. I'm happy doing it. So I can never give it up for anything.
If you could go back and change one thing, what would it be?
Oh, on that. If it's possible for me to change one thing, it's the initial capital I put in the first place, when I first started it. If it's possible for me to go back, I would have invested more into it. More, so much more. Because the more you put into this business, the better for anyone.
Okay, now, when was the last time you truly felt encouraged and supported, maybe by the government or any federal industry?
That has never happened though.
When was the last time you truly felt encouraged and supported?
On that, it's actually from a family member. My elder sister's husband helped me with a certain amount of money then to invest into the business. He actually gave the money to me to support me and for my business to be better. But presently, we don't have any help from the government.
What do you think life is about?
Life is, it's very short. Apart from the fact that it's short, while you are here, we should just do our own little part. Just do our own, the little we can do, we should do it without, you know, going beyond our capacity.
What is one thing that I could do that would dramatically improve your future?
So what can change this situation for us presently is if the government comes in to assist us on what we are facing presently, which is the issue of the swine fever. That's our major challenge presently. If the government can come in, let's say research is being carried out, the measures to put in place, or what are the things that can be done to really help us, the farmers, the pig farmers, to really move ahead. And also, if you are able to get finances for the betterment of our farms, I mean of the piggery farming, and it really help us.
If we never meet again, what is one thing you would like me to take away from this meeting?
That this piggery business is a very, very lucrative and a good business for anyone to invest into. What I would tell anyone is that this business is a type that if you invest in it, you can never ever regret it. You can never regret it. As well as livestock farming, you can never go into it and ever regret it.